What this programme does, more importantly than anything else in the UK, is that we understand completely what consumers want, and that's good quality, tender product, it's tasty, it's juicy, and of course consistency. We're able to translate that into a production model for our farmers to make sure that we've got a programme there that farmers can follow to deliver exactly what that customer wants. That sets us apart from any other supply chain in the UK.
And it's about bringing our beef business in line with the retailers, Blade, the processors, and the farmers, and the calf rears, all in one supply chain, all in one line. And so there's traceability right up through to the end product.
I'm not spending time running around trying to buy small numbers. And so that is my time. Fuel time is all cost money. We're getting a bonus on the finished animals. It's a small percentage we pay for them doing the work. Yes, it has definitely increased our profitability.
When Blade started 10 years ago, we started with a blank canvas, and we were able to then select really good quality alliance suppliers and partners to work with, so we could have a fantastic business where people understood what we were trying to achieve. We all strive for the same goals, and we all win from having a good quality partnership, such as Mole Valley Farmers, working with McDonald's, Fairfax Meadow, OSI, Tesco. Everybody understands what our business is about, and we all have an input to driving that business forward.
In 1999, McDonald's put Romford Wholesale Meats and OSI, who are our beef patty producers, together, and we gave them the task of finding a long-term solution to combat the expected changes to the subsidy system. And from this collaboration, Blade Farming was born, an integrated professional beef supply chain, using calves from the dairy herd and putting them through into our beef supply chain.
I know that some are going to Tesco, some are going to McDonald's, the retailers, and I can see that I've worked hard, and then people are going to McDonald's and eating their McDonald's beef burger, and they're enjoying the cattle that maybe I've grown on my farm. And that satisfaction is, you know, is part of the reason we're with Blade.
Once you know where your end market is and what you've got to supply for your end market, then you can work backwards. And that's what we did. Basically, we knew we had to produce a consistent product, and the way to look at it was that we looked at two industries, the pork, pig, and the chicken industry, and we knew that they got consistency. Their product was consistent. The way they do it is by batches, and we looked at that system and we knew we had to go down that road.
I think if there's any grey areas in a supply chain, it's going to fail, and you're going to have so much waste that any premium you get is going to get lost in that area of waste. So you have to be completely focused, and to a degree you have to be fairly ruthless. So if there's people in your supply chain that aren't doing what they're supposed to do, yeah, you either have to cajole them back into it or ask them to leave, because they're going to let the rest of the team down.
The Blade systems opened my eyes to what actually happens to the cow. I always thought of the finished product as just an animal. I'd never really considered it as meat. It's only through meeting the chefs through Blades that you realise how important getting the marbling through the meat is important for the finished product. They need consistent size and consistent colour.
Where Blade delivers the model, what we do is we deliver the nutrition that delivers the product. So I think Blade is unique within the industry as far as the calf rearing side of things, as far as economies of scale, but also their attention to detail. They run a KPI system, and we are very heavily involved with that. So we work with Blade and the rearers so we can measure and maximise, but also challenge how we can improve on each individual unit.
Our cattle performance is measured in every way. So it's daily live weight gain, it's feed conversion efficiency, it's feed cost of gain, and also it's any health issues that we may have. So all of the animals that we have will be measured in that way, and we turn that into a key performance indicator. And the role of my team, Gavin and Richard and Alexandra, is to sit down and work through that data, look at how some of our other producers are performing, and take best practice and just deliver. So every year we're just upping the game all the time. Just that one little bit, that 1.1 of a kilo daily live weight gain, can reduce the days on farm massively and give a much better return.
The other big part of the chain here in the UK is clearly we need to encourage dairy farmers to use the right bulls. And dairy farmers, clearly their number one objective is getting that heifer calved out safely and back in the parlour. So they're very, very interested in Angus genetics. So Blade Pharma are actually incentivising the dairy farmers with a system of vouchers which cover the price of the semen to actually, if you use the right bulls, when they buy the calf back, they'll give them the money back for the semen. And clearly to a dairy farmer, that's a fantastic thing. A, it's added value. And B, he actually has got a guaranteed market for his calf. His calf is sold before it's born.
Another good example of our partnerships is with Pfizer Animal Health. Pfizer write the health protocol for our calves.
They're coming off a load of different dairy units. We can't always guarantee whether they've had colostrum, what their disease management has been. They're all thrown together. So it's about getting protection in place fast enough to get them protected here. And then a few weeks later, we actually start a vaccine protocol with a broader vaccine with longer protection. And the reason for that vaccination is not about protecting the calves on this unit because it won't be working in time. It's about getting them protected before they move on to the finishing unit. So it's a little bit about investing up front to try and get the maximum return from these animals.
When I started Blade 10 years ago, I felt as though I was a lone voice in the industry. When I talked and shared with farmers what I wanted to achieve, half the farmers just said, you'll never achieve it. You know, you're wasting your time. Why would we want to do that? What's wrong with our product? Why would we want to change and do something completely different? But the other half of the farmers that I spoke to said to me, look, what we're doing is not efficient going forward. We're not connected. We don't really understand why we're producing animals in the way we do. It's more of a historic thing. So from my point of view, I really wanted to understand what was going to deliver the best quality beef. So I wanted to completely remove myself from current production systems and get involved in science to really understand what was going to excite a consumer.
One of the things that I really find easy as a businessman to run from the Blade system is that there is cost being taken out of the system. So I don't have to go buy cattle. That costs money. I have no disease issues at all, which is a huge cost and is completely hidden. And there's that premium at the end. So it's hard to put an exact figure on how much money we save by being in Blade. All I know is that we make a very healthy profit per carcass for everyone that leaves here. And the moment I had to start going to buy those calves, all the health issues, and actually play the market almost like a stockbroker, we'd lose money. I'm absolutely convinced of it. And the latest Eblex costings say that only about 25% of farmers in the UK make any real profit. And actually, I would guess that a vast majority of those 25% are in a vertical supply chain because they just have to be. They just haven't got time to go to Ross on Wye Market and try and buy 30 calves and 30 different places with 30 different strains of BVD and yonis and lepto and God knows everything else that comes with them. So that cost is just enormous and you never know what it is. So I think the costing saving is massive. I work on profit per space in the barns because we can only have so many cattle here, and therefore so it's profit per yard of space that we've got. And I know in Blade, after 5 years at it, that it is, for us, it's a fantastic system.
A Blade farmer is somebody that's got the right attitude. So we don't look at the farm to begin with. We meet the person involved, he or she, and just see how their attitude is in terms of producing to our model. If we can't get past that first stage, then we don't go any further because it's pointless.
A Blade farmer works out what the market wants and produces it to the highest spec and the best way that they possibly can. A run-of-the-mill farmer grows something and hopes somebody will buy it, and they're completely the whim of the market and they have no control.
So the early stages were very difficult, and it was also very difficult to demonstrate to farmers how they were going to get a real return from being in our business. So I took a risk. What I did was I went back to our shareholders within our meat business and said we need to take a risk and offer producers a guaranteed forward price mechanism to demonstrate to them that what we're doing is actually right. And we did that. You know, we took a risk on 5,000 cattle. It actually was good for us because what we found was that business risk we took developed some of the best quality cattle we'd ever had. It's very difficult to get new customers on board. So what we do is we do it through science. You know, Mr. Customer, what's important to you? How can I deliver something that would mean something to you? And then we produce it. And we go through the taste testings, we go through the cost models, we look at every aspect of their business. And to be honest with you, we get to a point where why wouldn't they want to buy our beef? Because it is better than anybody else's. So we stick to the facts.
The stigma within the English market is that Scotch beef is of a premium quality and a premium consistency. So the original relationship was a discussion with Blade Farming around how we could achieve that through an English beef brand and an English supply chain. We have a very strong relationship, which is probably unique between Fairfax Meadow and Blade. In particular, that myself at the sales and marketing end deal directly with the farm team and the farmers at Blade, because really I'm at the sharp end understanding what our customers are looking for and communicating that back to the guys that are producing the beef. That's unusual in the industry because it would normally be our buyers that are dealing with the processor or the farmer, and they wouldn't necessarily be buying on quality or consistency. There will be a price element there where that is kind of secondary to me to achieving the quality that my customer's looking for. Once we establish a relationship with Casterbridge and people understand the brand, understand the consistency, we never have a problem with it. So it allows us to work on our relationships and on other products and developing our business. And also, once we've got a Casterbridge customer, we've got them for life, providing the supply chain delivers as it has done for the last 4 years.
Genetics is very underused in the beef industry here in the UK. We're really scratching the surface of the potential. So my role is to make sure that the bulls that are Blade approved sires are doing as close to what Richard wants and the Blade team want for the sort of cattle they're looking for in the abattoir, and also making sure that the young bulls that we're creating for next year and the year after are exactly what they need, be that bigger ribeye, smaller ribeye, more tenderness, more marbling, good colour and a fantastic eating experience. There's enough data within the Angus breed, particularly using DNA or genomics, that we can make those breeding decisions and make sure the next generation of bulls are exactly what the consumer wants.
Calf rearers are offered a contract on a basis that we own the calves and we put in all the products. So if you like, it's a very prescribed system and they are paid a management fee. So what they produce is the building, the straw, the water, the penning. All right, we put in the calf, the milk powder, the feed and the medicines. So that's the initial contract for the calf rearer. Then moving on, once the calves are 84 days, they then go on to finishing farms. And basically, within 2 weeks of them being on the finishing farm, we offer them a forward contract, batch by batch. And on the Angus scheme, that would be a base price on the weekly price they go, when they go, on the week they go, plus 25p.
When the calves arrive on farm, the day after, Gavin or one of his team from Blade come and see me and they give me a contract, which we both sign, which is based on a pence per kilo above the market price, but with a guaranteed minimum set. So even if the beef price collapses in the next 12 months, we have a guaranteed minimum, but every contract I've done so far, we've always beaten that level.
Before we even get the cattle on farm, we can set our budgets and we know exactly where we're going and where we're going to end up. And also with the diets as well, before we were just feeding a bit of barley, sort of nearly ad hoc really, but now we know exactly how many kilos we're feeding per day and what the feed mix is, you know, how much of different minerals and vitamins and we're putting into the feed. And it's all that has really, Blade has really helped us to really get, it's to fine tune our business really, to get our beef business really singing. Whereas before we were just plodding along, now we're steaming, now we're motoring, and that's what Blade has allowed us to do.
I've certainly learned, they've helped us to learn by different people they bring down and we meet and we understand what we got to do, and if we don't get it right, they can't get it right, and then we will lose our customers. So it does come back as a